Hey, hi everyone. So this is our Cucumber tutorial session 8, and in this tutorial we'll be specifically looking into the advanced reporting structure of the Cucumber. Okay, so let me have a look for our agenda today. So Cucumber advanced reporting structure using extend reporting. Okay, so let me show you and give you some idea about the, what is the extend reporting. Okay, first let me take you to the extend report. What is extend reporting? So if you search that option in the Google, you will get this page, this site that is very much detailing about extend reporting. So in Cucumber, basically, I mean, we are already having some pretty reporting, and if you are using the TestNG format, then you are already having the TestNG default reporting. Okay, and using the Maven also, you can have the Shareware plugin, you can have the Shareware HTML reporting also. Okay, apart from that, XSLT report you can also have, but one of the most important part, the reporting structure we have, it should be much more rich and detailed, right? So in that case, we'll be using the extend reporting. This is the much more advanced and detailed reporting of the Cucumber feature. Okay, so if we go to the site, you can read about the documentation over there. Like extend report is a logger style API written for Java and .NET environment, which allow creating HTML report from test. And let me have a look how extend reporting basically looks like. If you search that, as we have seen before on the Cucumber tutorial, we have only seen the pretty reporting format, okay, and the TestNG default reporting format. But in the extend reporting format, you will get much more detail like this. Okay, so let me take you to my clips and let me show you how to configure the extend reporting in Cucumber. Okay, and then we'll run a feature file and we'll see the result. Okay, so this is the feature file, make my triplet feature, that I'm going to run and I will observe the output in the extend reporting format. So first let me take you to how to configure the extend reporting. Okay, so as I'm using the Cucumber Maven based project, so what about the dependency you want to add for extend reporting jar file? That POM, that dependency need to be added in the Maven POM XML if you are using Maven, else you can add the download the jar file and add it to your project class path. That also you can do. Okay, so I'm going to get into the POM XML and let me show you. Okay, so see, this is the dependency I've added. You can see, I guess, for extend reporting, you can get the jar from this site, Maven repository at effect.com, netmaster cucumber reporting. And the extend reporting format URL also has been given. So for first dependency, I have added Cucumber extend reporting jar. It's 2.0.2 version. Now, I mean, already latest version already has been there. So you can also try with the latest version. Okay. And then I'm using the dependency version extend report com.11 codes group ID and version 2.41.2. Okay. And then com.avenstack extend report version 3.0.3. okay, so all these three dependencies must be added in the POM XML before you proceed with the extend reporting. Okay, and second is for the Cucumber pretty and JSON format. Apart from this, if you want JSON format, yeah, text format reporting along with the HTML format reporting, you can also add this netmaster.cucumber reporting 3.5.1. And this dependency need to add. Now one question may arise, how we will get the jar file or the POM dependencies? Okay, so just it's basically simple things. Just search Cucumber reporting, action reporting, POM dependency. So you can see extend reporting for Selenium. So you could take the latest versions, you can navigate to here, and using the Maven based whatever the POM XML has been given, that you can dependency sections, you can add the same in your POM XML. Okay, that I have added already. So for this version, I will be using the 2.41.2. I guess this is the latest version extend reporting. Okay, so those three dependency must need to be added your POM XML. Apart from that, if you are using Maven, you must need to have this two plugin, and one is the Maven plugin, Maven Shareware plugin, and these two plugins should be needed, and the other is Maven compiler plugin. So what this plugin are needed for? I mean, I have already written why it is needed, that adding Maven compiler plugin and Shareware plugin is mandatory the compiler plugin is to compile the source of your project. Okay, so that's why it's mandatory. If you are using Maven Plus project, then it is a mandatory plugin you need to have. Okay, and see in the plugin itself, I also mentioned inside the build that the Maven compiler plugin I'm using the version 3. You can get the latest version from the Maven repository. In the configuration, I mentioned which is the Java exe file, the path I have given. That path will be given in the executable tag, and the sources and target. The version I'm using 1.8, that version I have given. Okay, fork is equal to true. So if you're using a Maven Plus project, you can just copy and paste the same or just change the version, so you can do it yourself and get some experiment with this. Okay. But before proceeding with the extended report, before adding this 3 jar, I've shown you 3 jars. You must need to have this two plugin also, the Maven compiler plugin and Surefire plugin. Another important plugin is the Surefire plugin that I've written that it used during the test phase of the build lifecycle. Okay, to execute the unit test of an application, it generates reports into different file formats, XML files and plain text files. Okay, the another important thing is that if you're using Maven, so you can also generate the HTML file, HTML reporting structure of the Surefire report. Okay, so if you use that plugin, you can also get the HTML reporting structure from Maven. So in that plugin, I mentioned the group ID, artifact ID, the version I'm using, and here in the configuration, I have mentioned includes. I mean, this is the syntax for regular expressions I've used. So in case if you are using GeoUnit runner, your test engine runner, so whatever the runner class you want to execute using the POM XML, if you are going to run your POM XML, run your test classes, test runner classes using the Maven test, then you need to mention this way. Okay, suppose you are going to run my POM XML this way, the Maven test, run as Maven test. So whatever the runner class name has been mentioned, it will execute it only this way. Okay, so there is currently I'm only included the demo.java using the regular class expression. So if I run the POM XML, so it will run the test.demo. It will try to find any classes that end into demo. Okay, another important thing in the Maven Surefire plugin, if you want to get the Maven Surefire plugin reporting structure, then you can also add this plugin for group ID and artifact ID Maven Surefire plugin and version 2.20. And apart from this, also you can add the plugin details reporting structure for your Maven based projects. So if you want to get the Maven Surefire HTML reporting. Okay, so in my case, I only using the extend reporting structure, so I will be talking about it later, how to get the Maven based reporting. That's also good reporting, but I will suggest that if you are using extend reporting format, then you don't need this. Okay. Okay, so we are done with these three dependency sections for Cucumber Advanced extend reporting part, and then we are done with this two Maven Surefire plugin and Maven compiler plugin. Okay. Now after adding those dependency, you will see if you save it, it will get added in the Maven dependency sections as a in the jar file. So okay, for this we can see Cucumber extendable 2.0.2. Yeah, so let me show you where it is. Okay, Cucumber extendable 3.0.3 added. Okay, and extend reporting jar that got added, and Cucumber extend reporting, let me show you where it is. Yeah, Cucumber extra reporting version 2.0.2 jar that has been also added. Okay, so after the configuring the Cucumber POM XML, yeah, after configuring the Cucumber POM XML, now you have to do one simple step, the extend configurations XML file. Okay, so in that configuration file, I will config the whatever the dependency for extend report I have added. I will configure all those details. Okay, so this is the XML file you need to have must if you are using the extend reporting structure, and you can just copy paste the same for your application. I use it anyway. So in that structure, you can see that in the under the extended reporting format, under the configuration or theme, I have used a standard theme. Encoding UTF-8 I have used, and protocol version HTTPS. And document title I've given as extend report, and report name I want to get as a JUnit test and a Kokoma reporting. So you can change it according to your applications. If you want, you can modify it, configure it. Reporting headline, I haven't given reporting headline, but you can give it reporting headline, what is the report is all about, something details. Date format you can given like YYYYMMDD I have given. Time format you can also set, and that this is a custom JavaScript you need to give. That will fetch the details from your test runner class, after the test runner class, and it will embed the things in your reporting structure. Okay, so this all this reporting details, I mean that I maintained the extent underscore config.xml, you need to maintain this XML under your class pass. Okay, so Cucumber Maven project, and if you navigate to the build path, configure build path. At the time of you can no sorry not this yeah you can also need to have this. I already have the dependency. Okay, not from here, let me show you. Okay, I mean for you can also add the dependency as a runtime configuration. So you can go to the run configurations, and if you enable the class path under this user entries, you need to add, you need to have your own project class path. Okay, so the Cucumber Maven project, that project already has been embedded into that class path runtime configurations. So that extend config file that I'm talking about is already inside that Cucumber Maven project, right? So that already has been taken care. Okay, so first we will do the adding the POM dependency in the XML XML file of the POM XML, and second thing we'll be doing in the creating an extend configuration XML file, and we will be using those details. Okay, make sure you are giving the correct details, and if you use any kind of, if there is any some invalid details, then you won't get the report and you will give you some wrong info, wrong error. Okay, so we are pretty much done about the extend configuration file, how we can set the jar and config, create the config file. Now it's time to execute some feature, and let's see about the result. Okay, so for my case, I will be executing the make my feature, that user sign in. So there is only one feature that I'm executing, sign in validations, and what inside that feature, there are basically three scenarios I'll be checking for the single user sign in by Facebook. So when you navigate to the make my tip site, you will be having some login option. Okay, so clicking on the login options, you will choose I want to log in as a Facebook customer. Okay, so see, I click on the login, check continue with Facebook, or login with Google and login page, click continue with Facebook sign in properly, and you will, after that you have to provide the Facebook ID details, and we'll get to log in into the make my trip sections. Okay, so after you get to log into the make my trip sections, now you have to click on the logout, and after that click on the logout, user should be able to logged out successfully. Okay, the second scenario stated that footer validation and authenticity. So after the login is successful, you need to validate this footer in the make my trip page. For the footer, I have mentioned this inside the doc string. The doc string feature I have talked earlier in my previous tutorial, so you can refer that. Okay, so after validating this footer in the authenticator stage, we will be clicking on the logout, and user should be able to log out successfully. And the same thing we'll be doing in third step also. We will be validating the MMT footer validation for unauthenticator. So when user haven't logged in, it's unauthenticator stage, we will need to check the footer sections. Okay, for this we have implemented a glue code in the step definition markery. So this is my glue code. If you extend this, whatever the things I've imported, and this is my before class that I mentioned, after class is mentioned. So in that case, okay, in the Cucumber feature, in the advanced reporting, extended reporting format, the good thing is that if you want to have your screenshot for each and every step, you can embed your screenshot in the reporting structure itself. Okay, so for my case, I haven't used the each and every step screenshot. It will be huge, then it will increase the size of my report. Okay, so in case if you have any failure of your execution, so in that case only the relevant screenshot will be taken, and it will embed into the report. Okay, in case if you have any failure. Okay, so I mentioned this one in the after class. If scenario is failed, the scenario.embed text screenshot divert the Selenium text screenshot class have a code used. Scenario to rabbit text screenshot driver get screenshot as output dot types output type dot bytes and image dot png. Okay, and let me have a look, and all those steps have been mentioned implemented in my glue code properly. Okay, so I have used so many assertions as it is being the full flow of user sign in and login. So meanwhile, I have used so many assertions in that page itself, validating each and every steps. Okay, so okay. One more thing, so external reporting configuration file that has been done. Okay, and after that you also have to create which folder you want to target. Let me open it. That the things I have given, and you also need to have this reporting structure. I have maintained all my reporting structure there under the report sections. So inside the report section I have maintained three folders. The three folders name and the reporting structure that I mentioned in my test runner classes. So let me have a look on my test runner classes. Okay, so in the test runner classes that I've discussed earlier about the details in the plugin sections, if you see that the standard output, the pretty format, it will get into the HTML format, it will get into the eDrive Eclipse Selenium project Cucumber Maven. I've given the full path here. Okay, so report and Cucumber pretty. So under the Cucumber Maven project, it's coming to the report folder and Cucumber pretty folder. So inside that Cucumber pretty folder, you will get the pretty reporting format. Same way for JSON, I mentioned this will store as the Cucumber Maven project reporting structure, Cucumber JSON, and the Cucumber JSON format. Cucumber.json format, you will get just as a JSON format. Okay, and for extend reporting, I have used the com.cucumber listener class of extend Cucumber report formatter, and it will store as a Eclipse Selenium Cucumber Maven project, then comes to the report folder and Cucumber extend folder. Okay, and the report name will be report.html that I have mentioned. So report.html will be there inside that report Cucumber extend folder that I've created. Okay, I mentioned the whole path here. Okay, and tags I've talked about earlier about the detail what about the tags I'm gonna use. So for this case I'll be using the three tags: make matrix, sign in, validation, footer validation, auth and footer validation. Okay, and the things I've skipped earlier, that update class, or why we need all those things. So in the update class, if you have look onto that, I have incorporated the embedded the extend configuration XML file that I have created for extend reporting that I have embedded in included in the update class file, public static void report setup and a reporter.load XML file config file. New file, the file's full path I've given. Okay, or you can give the just class path, I mean where the file is located, if it is inside the class path only. Okay, so for that load XML file config, okay, so reporter dot load XML file XML config. So it will take the file, it will take the configurations from that from that path from the XML file, and it will load the configuration in our reporting structure. And the reporting structure I want to get the below info need to be get printed. Okay, so set dot system info. This is the user properties actually. So if you want to print all the properties to be included in your file, you can just write this way: properties p equal to system.getProperties and p.list system.out. So all those properties will get printed. Accordingly, if you want, you can embed those things in your report itself. So for my case, I have only used this. So username will get printed, user time zone, and what of the system I'll be using that will get printed. The Selenium version I'm using, current Maven version I'm using, according to the Java versions on the Cucumber test and reporting, the name will get printed. Besides this, you can also print out the other properties also. There's so many properties. Okay, so just let's do and run this, and we have a look on this. Okay, okay, so we are done with extend reporting formats. First we have added jar, Second thing, we have configured the extend reporting extend configuration file of XML. Third important thing that in the runner class I mentioned the detailed path of the Cucumber extend formatter, and we also include the details of the report setup. Whatever the properties we can add, we can also add the other properties also. Okay, so now it's time to run the class. I will see the result. Run as a unit test. So in my case, I'm using the IE browser. Okay, so IE browser is getting opened. And let's see what is executing. It's executing the single info signing by Facebook. Okay, that's good. It's a bit much slow due to its IE. So we have three scenarios inside that. So it will take some time. Okay, so let me do one thing. It will take some time to execute all this feature and the scenario. So I'm halting my recording as of now, and we'll come back once this is the scenario got executed successfully. Okay. So here you can see that all my scenario got executed successfully. Okay. It is a pretty long scenario. Let me have a look on it. The scenario 1 executed successfully, then following scenario 2, and then scenario 3. Okay, so all the scenario got executed successfully, and I can also see the console window. Like first this scenario, executing scenario single user sign in by Facebook, and then again testament setup, footer validation in authenticated stage, and last one is footer validations in unauthenticated stage. Okay. So there was total 3 scenario and 3 got passed successfully, 38 step and time it took. Okay. So let's me now have a look on that. The reporting structure. Okay. So after that test runner class executed successfully, as you mentioned in the plugin sections, all the reporting structure should get generated. So now I'm moving to the reports file, report sections. So first standard output pretty report format will get generate. Let me have a look on it. So in case if you have any case failure, I mean some network issue or application issue, so that it will embed the screenshot as mentioned in the after class, and along with the main functionality of the Cucumber pretty, it will generate the report for index or HTML. This is the Cucumber pretty report. It's a simple format report. First have a look on it. I mean, okay, this is the report you will get for Cucumber pretty formatter. Okay, let me close it. I will open it from the browser. So first see the difference, and it's pretty much simple report. Nothing has been detail mentioned. I mean, simple format report is good, but if you want more advanced reporting, then let me have you go to the Cucumber extend report feature. I want to also mention that Cucumber JSON reporting, you can also consider this reporting. It's opening not properly. Open with the system editor. Let me open it this way. Let me go to the path of this. Where is located? Sorry. Selenium project, Cucumber Maven. And then reporting structure, Cucumber JSON. Let me open it. Notepad. Oh. Okay, so the JSON format reporting, you can see it's also given the details of the steps, the line, the value, and every durations, and the status if it is passed or not, and the location of the glue code. Everything has been there in the JSON format reporting also. Okay, but for your use, we need to understand the reporting format in HTML. It's much more readable than the JSON format. Okay, so this is the Cucumber extra reporting format generated the report.html. Let me have a look on it. So it's opening for a while. It's taking time to load. Let me close this one. It's taking some time. Wait for a while. Meanwhile, we can open the report from the Chrome also. Like if you navigate to the project directory. So here from the Cucumber external report, we can get the report. Report.html generated. Okay. So here is the report. The report got generated at 11:15:52. That time is getting displayed. The versions. And in the report, this will be in the dashboard. You can see the status. Status you can set filter wise, like pass or fail you want to get. Category the how much total scenario that I have executed in my cases, in my feature file. That will be displayed. What is the category of the feature file? Dashboard is a dashboard which scenario have you taken? The feature file have taken your sign-in validation tested that is passed successfully. And if any failure, it will be highlighted here in the red mark itself. Okay, and these sections you can use the filtering. Okay, for my case, all the scenario got fast success with the taking the first scenario, single user sign in via Facebook. Under this scenario, we have several steps like given. So you can go to the steps, we can see that the timestamp, enable status, and the indicator are given. Okay, okay. And one more thing, whatever the data you pass, it will also get displayed. Okay, here we are passing the data, that the data is getting displayed, the details, and you passing the password, it will get displayed. So after the first scenario, it will come to the second scenario. We can see this is also passed, so we can also see the details here. So this way you can also, this way you can able to see the details of your scenario that you have executed using the test runner classes, and it will get listed in the Cucumber external reporting. Okay, and this tab, it will take you to the categories. This categories tab, you will get into the details here. You can see that the three categories, like three scenario that has been mentioned, and all we can see that the timestamp and the test name has been given. Clicking on that, it will take you to the dashboard page. Okay, the categories, you can search which step you want to go navigate. You can search in that area. And take me to this field. Okay, in this field we can see that you test a total 38 steps and total 38 steps pass successfully. Okay, steps 42 is showing as we have used hooks. Okay, total test steps of 38, and there are some common steps between the scenario. So total steps of 42 or 38 steps were unique steps that all got executed successfully. And we can get the info from here, like info 4 plus 38, time taken, total amount time taken, when the state, when you've started execution, and when the execution execution was done. Category wise, you can see the pass, fail, and other things in this category. If your case is failing due to some reasons, it will get listed as a fail with red mark. And the scenario that this thing's environment that I mentioned in this. Let me take you to the test runner classes. Okay, in the test runner classes, in the after class that I mentioned, all this reporting reported the set system info, the system properties I want to get printed in the report itself. Okay, so these all are getting printed in that, like username, time zone, which Windows I'm using, who is the operating system using. You can also detail the version here, the Cucumber Cucumber version, you are using Java versions along with all the software requirements, so everything you can get that from the properties. Okay, so you can get the details. You can say the details here itself, report address or site info, properties you want, and property system.get property username. It will get listed. Okay, let me come to the next tag, Cucumber and logs. So here, if you are using any logs like log4j object or log, that will get printed in the log sections. For my case, I haven't used any logs, I only use the console output like sysprint element. So that's only the sysprint, and then that's only the text is getting displayed that I only have used during my executions. Okay, but for better maintenance and for good protein structure, you should have mentioned your own log file, and that log file used to will help you to debug your applications. Okay, so we'll come to the log file section later. So that's, we can pretty much see about the Cucumber extended reporting format and see the difference between that. I mean, if you go to that, I mean, let me just clear the filter first. Dashboard. So if you see the difference between the extended report format and the Cucumber normal pretty report format, you can easily get the difference. Like, it's much more detailed and rich content has been incorporated in this feature file that is helpful for us, for large project. Okay, but if you have some smaller project, you can use this inbuilt feature of the Cucumber standard output HTML file that is also helpful. Okay, and one more thing, guys, like the extend reporting format, you can also have the XSLT reporting format, and that you can also have. You can take any one. I mean, according to the project requirement, you can choose whatever the reporting format your project is. It's project requirement, you can choose. Okay. And one more thing, last time I show you that if you are using TestNG, so in that case, the TestNG default test format you will get. So this case I've run as a JNU test, so I won't get any TestNG report format. But if you use the TestNG, you can also get the TestNG report format like email level report.html, report.html. Let me have a look. So this way you will get this is the TestNG format report. It's giving some time. I don't know. It's pretty much slow. Yeah. So TestNG report, you can see that you can get the TestNG report this way also. So TestNG by default will help to generate the report, and you can also use. Apart from it, if you are using Maven based project, and if you plug in CFI plugin for HTML report, you can also get the report from the Maven itself. Okay, Maven status. Sorry, not here. Maven CFI report, and from itself you can also get the CFI. Sorry. You can also get the CFR report, CFR suite, CFR test or HTML. Let me have a look. Okay, so you can get the report this way. Okay, CFR test, when the test has been started and the test has been closed, pass successfully, all the reports yourself. This report you can configure much more detail. You need to mention the detailed reporting and the configurations in the POM structure file, POM file. So I would suggest if you want to go for the advanced reporting, you can use this extend reporting format. This is pretty much good and detailed reporting that the other reporting available right now in the market. Okay, so that's all for today for Cucumber reporting format, advanced reporting, and all other reporting. So if you guys have any questions to set up the how to set up this extend reporting format, just let me know in the comment sections. And the next tutorial I'll be discussing about how we can set up the Cucumber in the Jenkins tool, and we'll run the feature file in the POM XML through the Jenkins. Okay, so thanks guys, thank you for watching.